Hey guys, this is Khadeen and you are watching Grow with Khadeen. In this video, you will learn how to create a responsive and mobile friendly WordPress website for your CV, resume or a portfolio, personal portfolio website for you. So let's just get started and just create the web. Before just starting the video, I just want to tell you that this website doesn't require any coding skill, doesn't require any technical skill. You will just make few clicks and your website is ready. You don't have to create any content. You just have to replace the text, the images, and your website is all set. And you can just add your image here, and this is the about section. Let's just give an overview to the site. So this is the logo, and after that you can give your number, email, your CV link, your Messenger or WhatsApp or any chatting channel link. You can just add your text here. Hi, I am Khadeen. I can add that and all your information, hire me link, and also some social links if you want. Then you have a services section where you can add your services and you can link the services to a services page. And if we go below, you have a skills section where you can just add your skills, the areas you are skilled in, and you can change the pictures here. And after that is your qualification and experience. You can add that also. And after that, it's your portfolio, that how much years of experience you have, how much you have satisfied clients. And after that, you have some of the portfolios that you have, the companies you have worked with or the works you have done. And then you have a testimonial sections that what your clients are saying about you. And then you have a tools section where you can list your tools, the tools you are using right now. Okay, so, and at the end of that, you have a contact me section where user can contact you, your client can contact you. And then you have a footer with contacting information. So let's just get right into the video and create complete website. Before just starting the video, make sure you have subscribed to my YouTube channel and click on bell icon. And one thing more to say, that watch this full video till the end, because if you watch this full video till the end, you will get $300 gifts just for free. Everyone watching this video will get these $300 worth gifts just for free. So watch this full video till the end. But before just creating the website, you need two things, and these two things are mandatory. First one is your domain name, and the second one is hosting of your website, on which your website will be hosted. Now, if you don't know what the domain name and hosting is, domain name is the name of the website. Like if you want to go to Apple website, you type in apple.com. You want to go to Google website, you type in google.com. So if someone wants to go to your website, he needs a domain name, and that's what we'll buy. And I'll tell you that how you can get that domain name for free. And the hosting is a fast computer which on which your website files are stored and which delivers the files to the user or to viewers, and you need to buy that space. But there are a lot of companies who are just providing the both of these things at the same place with cheaper prices. But I would recommend you HostGator.com. Why? Because of their pricing plans and their services. Now there are other companies like Kinsta, which is starting at $30 per month. But you can see the HostGator is starting at $2.75 per month with the same speed, same performance, and same support and same features. There is also another company which is hostwise.com, and they are providing the same services at $6.74 per month. And there's also a company which are providing it at only $1.99 per month. I have given the discount links to all these companies below in description, and you can just check them out. But this company, I didn't like their technical support, I didn't like their performance, etc. So I wouldn't recommend you any of these three or any other companies I have listed below. I would recommend you to go with HostGator.com. Why? Because of their customer support service, and also because of their other features their technical support, performance, and all that stuff. You don't have to do anything. Their support team will do everything for you. So to buy that, it's a lot easy. You just have to select a plan. Now they have three plans. First one is Hatchling plan. If you only need one website, then Hatchling plan is better for you. But if you are if you just want to start a blog in future or an e-commerce site in future, and you don't want to buy the hosting again, you can just select baby plan, and you can create unlimited websites with that, with one click WordPress installed, unlimited bandwidth, and you will get free domain name with all their plans. So I would recommend you to go with this one. Why? Because you are getting a 64% discount if you will go from my link in description below. And also you can see here, you will get a free domain name, free SSL certificate and a lot things for free, and you will get a free CDN also. So to buy the hosting, what you have to do is you just have to click on buy now, select the plan and click on buy now, and you will be redirected to the buying page. There you just have to enter the details. Now which details? Let's just select there. First of all, you will have to select a domain name. You can see here is you will get a free domain name if you will go from my link. So you will just have to select, I'll just select khadeenakbarcv.com. okay, so I'll just click on hit enter button. I'll just select .com and it is searching for that, and the domain name is available. Okay, so I'll get that domain name just for free. Now I'll just come below and I'll just select a plan from here. Which the plan I just chosen? So I just choose that one. Okay, so which plan I just chosen? I chose that baby plan and I'll go with that, and I'll just pay for 36 months. Now why for 36 months? Because I will get it at only at $3.50 per month. Like you saw there, it was about $3.75 per month, and I am getting it at only $3.50 per month if I'll buy it for 36 months. Okay, the hatchling plan was 2.75, but the baby plan is for 3.75. okay, and then you just have to enter your mail address and etc. all information. You just have to set a PIN, you just have to set a password, and after that okay, so after that you just have to enter your name, email, phone number, company, etc. And here you just have to add your credit card, debit card information, or you can pay with PayPal if you want, and enter the PayPal exemption ID here. And I would recommend you to go with credit card because it's a lot easier, and I think it's good. So you can also go with PayPal. Okay, so there you just have to enter Khadeen64 to validate that discount. Now I have already validated this discount, so that's why I was seeing that. Now the discount is validated, and now you can see you are getting the complete hosting at only $150 for 3 years. Now $150 is what some hosting companies cost for one month, and you are getting it the complete web hosting with unlimited websites, 24/7 chat support, instant account approval, and also some hosting add-ons just for $150 for 3 years. So after doing that, you just have to select that and you have to click on checkout after adding your payment details, and you just have to click on checkout. And after doing that, I will not go to checkout page because I have already bought that hosting. So you will have to select a CMS, and you will have to select a WordPress CMS, and after selecting that, you will need some information and you will be redirected to this page. This is the page on which you will create the website. So after you have been redirected to this page, you have bought the hosting, you have did everything technical. Now it's all just like using Microsoft Paint, or you can say a photo editor app that you just have to, or you can say Microsoft Word, Google Docs to just create a website. Then we'll have to do some basic settings in WordPress. Now how we'll have to do some basic settings in WordPress? You can just go to settings, go to general, and here in general settings, what we'll have to do is we have just have to change the name of the website. I just said Khadeen Akbar, and professional web developer and digital marketer. Okay, and after that you can change the email also, and here you can change the site language, your time zone. Now my time zone is Pakistani time zone. I'll not select that, but you can all do that, and you can just select the cashier level and all things etc., and click on save changes. And after you have clicked on save changes, your all the changes are being saved, and then you just have to go to the pages or go to all pages and clear these pages. Now you just have to click on the title. I just did it very fastly. I'll just go to hosts, and there what you have to do is just have to click on all above, click on select move trash and click on apply, and that's how you will remove all the trash pages. So we have done with all the basic WordPress settings, and now we'll need to install a WordPress theme. And how we can install that WordPress theme, and this is a free WordPress theme, we'll just go to appearance and themes, and in themes section we'll click on add new, and after clicking add new we'll just go to search themes and we'll search for a theme called Hello Elementor. And after searching for that WordPress theme, we'll just install that WordPress theme. And now you can see the WordPress theme is installed. We'll just click on activate and the theme will be activated. And now it's asking to install Elementor. So just click on install Elementor, and our Elementor plugin is installed, and click on activate to activate it. And our Elementor plugin is activated for right now. Now after the theme installation, we'll need to install a plugin. So to install that plugin, we'll just have to go to plugins and click on add new. And after clicking on add new, we'll be just redirected to the repository, and almost most of the things are just for free. We'll just have to buy one or two things, and we have bought one of them, and we need to buy another thing, and it's only for $10 to $20, and that's all. And all the other stuff is just for free. And here what we can do is, what you just have to search for Envato Elements. So here in Envato Elements, and click on install now. This is the first plugin, and click on activate. So all our required plugins are installed right now. So as now our WordPress plugins are installed right now, you just have to click on the link below, or you can just go to webifiedhub.com. Sorry, I'll go from there. webifiedhub.com/prokit, or you can just go to link in description, and you will need a template kit which will integrate in our website and which is the basis of our website design. So this is the template kit which we will just install in our WordPress website, and if you will go from my link, you will get it only for $17 or maybe for $19, but you will get benefits, okay? And you just have to go to the link and you just have to buy this WordPress Elementor template kit. Now this is the portfolio template kit, and you just have to click on buy now to buy this template kit. Or if you don't like that template kit, you can search for other template kits, and the process I'll just tell you is the same. You can just apply the same settings, okay? And you will just have to install that template kit. So how to buy this template kit? Just click on buy now button. And after clicking on buy now button, you will have to add some details. I have already an account with themeforest.net, so I just don't have to add any details. You will have to add your name, your company name, or your like address, etc. And after adding that, you will have to add some payment method. I'll just select PayPal, and you can just check out with PayPal and buy this only for $17, okay? And handling fees is $2. Handling fees is, I think, required. So after doing that, after you have bought, you just have to go to your profile and you just have to click on downloads, and your download file will be available there, and you just have to download that item from there. Here the file will be available and you just have to download that file. Now after we have bought and installed that template kit, what we will have to do is, we'll just have to go to the elements section, element section, click on install kits, and after going there, you just have to click on upload template kit zip file, and you just have to select that template kit file. So where's the template kit file? So this is the template kit file. You just have to select that template kit file and your template kit file will be uploaded. So now our template kit is imported and you just have to click on install requirements and install all the required plugins in your WordPress website. It would take a while to just install all these WordPress plugins, so you just have to wait for that. After the template kit file is imported, what we have to do is we just have to create some required pages. Now which pages we need? So first of all, we'll just import that global kit styles, and we need to create a home page, an about page, a my services page, a portfolio page, a contact me page, and a 404 page. Now 404 page if you want, and also a coming soon page if you are going to if you have launched your website and you need to create a coming soon page also, so you can also create that. So we'll just go to all pages and I'll just click on add new and I'll just open it in new tab, so this page is available to me. Okay, so this is the page here for me, and what I'll do is I'll just add a title here. I'll just add home as a title here, and in template I'll just choose it as full width and I'll just publish it. And after publishing it, what I will do is I'll just click on edit with Elementor, and after clicking there I'll just delete that tab, and now you can see a new page is created if we refresh, and it is edit with Elementor. So you just have to repeat the process to create other page. I just clicked on add new, I'll just select the title again, I'll just go to template and select full width, and I'll just click on publish, and after the page is being published I'll just click on edit with Elementor, and after clicking on that I'll just go back. And now I am here, and if I would refresh this, I have a new page here. Then I'll again go to add new, and if you have learned that, you can just skip that step and you can just turn out to next step, but I'll just tell you how to create each page. So there are the pages, and here I have created home and about, and then I'll just go to contact. I'll just have created home, contact, and I'll just go to about page. Now I'll just select Elementor full width, I'll click on publish and select edit with Elementor, and when it is like that I'll just go back. Okay, and now again I'll just click on add new, and now a portfolio page is required and services page is required, so I'll just select portfolio. From here I'll select Elementor full width, click on publish, again click on publish, and edit with Elementor, and I'll just go back again. Now the last page is required because I'll not create 404 or coming soon page, and this is not I think so required also. So I'll now which page is required? Now portfolio page is required only, so I'll just go to pages, add new, and I'll name it as portfolio Elementor full width, publish, and edit with Elementor. So this is what I'll do, and now we have all our pages created. So here you can see we have all the required pages: about, contact, home, portfolio, services, and you can also create under construction if you want, and the process will be the same, and those are the pages we'll create. And now after creating the pages, what we have to do is we just have to go to appearance and menus to create a menu here. And the menu is something that you know is a very bigger requirement, and after that we just have to select the menu name. I'll just select it as header menu, and display location is header, and I'll just click on create menu to create a new menu. And after this is created, the menu is created, I'll just click on view all in pages section, and I'll just add a click on select all and will add all the pages to this menu. And now you can see home, about, contact, and all the pages are included there, but I think home is created two times, so I'll just delete it and come back. But before just deleting and coming back and all that stuff, I'll just not add that one, and I'll just click on save menu. And now you can see our menu is created, and how we can delete that page. We can just go to the pages, go to all pages, and here if we have two home pages, we have one home page, I think. Yep, there was an error. Okay, so we have a complete like website menu created, and now what we'll do is we'll just go to our website, which is sports.com, and we'll just go to our website and we'll see how our website is looking right now. So that's how our website is looking right till right now. So we have home page, about page, contact page, portfolio page, and services page. Now here we can see here our home page is not showing. How our home page is not active, but our archives page is active. This is a default page by WordPress. So I just want to set home for it. Okay, so I'll just go back and we'll just go to settings, and I'll just go to reading. And after going to reading, I'll just click on static, and I'll just select home as a home page, and I'll just click on save changes. And now you can see changes are saved, and now if we'll refresh it, so now you can see our home page is here, and edit with Elementor option is available here. Now we have menus and we have all that stuff. We'll just edit the header and footer of the website. We'll just add header and footer of the website. Like you can see how header and footer of the website is like. Like you can see it is the header of the website, and the website header of this website is pretty lazy and too ugly. So we'll just go to appearance. We'll just go to header and footer builder. And after going to there, we just click on add new. And I'll just select beginner, and for myself I'll just click on submit. I'll just skip it, and again so I just clicked on add new. Now what you have to do is you just have to select here header, select option, and you just have to select it as header, display on entire website, and I'll just click on publish here. And it is published, and I'll just click on edit with Elementor. And when we'll just click on edit with Elementor, our Elementor page builder will be loaded, where we'll just create the website, we'll just edit the website, and we'll just do all the stuff that is required to build the websites. Okay, so here we'll just build the header. How we'll build the header, we'll just go to third option, which is green, and Envato elements. We'll just go to installed kits section. We'll just go to pro kit section, and here we'll seek about for header section. Okay, so where is the header section hidden? Yep, there it is. So I'll just click on insert template. It might take some time to be inserted, and it would be imported in your website within a few seconds. Now you can see the header is imported here. Now how to change the logo and all that stuff, you just have to go to each page, each section. Now here the logo, what you have to do is you just have to click on choose image, and you can just upload a logo of yourself. Now how you can create a logo for yourself, you can just go to freelogodesign.org, and there you can just create a free logo for yourself. Now I'll not create a logo right now because it's a lot easy to create, and I'll just upload a pre-made logo which I have already made. So here's the logo of my company. I'll just upload it, and here's the logo. I'll just click on insert media, and you can see my logo is imported. Now here you can just click on that, and you can edit that text, and you can edit your own number. I'll not now edit all the things because it will take a lot of time. I'll just enter my email address here, and here you can edit the address to your CV. Now your CV, you can upload it on your Google Drive, your CV on your Google Drive, and you can just copy off the link of that CV on from Google Drive, or you can just create a Word document and you can just copy the link to that and you can just paste it here, so anyone can download your CV, and you can just add Instagram DM link or your Messenger chat link or your WhatsApp link here for what Let's Chat. And here is the menu section, so here you can add a menu here, but here is header menu. So how you can add the menu here, I'll just tell you, but right now we can just select header menu here, and I would recommend you to select the header menu here. And also you can add a schema support here if you want, and you can just make some other changes if you want in that stuff. Like if you just click on that, you have home, about, contact, portfolio section, and here in the last menu item you can select a button here if you want to add a button here, and you can add also a button here, and you can just change the logos here, you can just redirect to save link, etc. And there are a lot of settings you can do. And if you will go to styles, you can edit the styles of this that section here. You can edit the styles of the menu, of the trigger, and a lot, etc. So here you will, when you will click there, you will see you have a lot of options there for mobile, how it is looking on mobile, how it is looking on tablet, and how it is looking on computer. Okay, so we'll just go to logo and we'll see our logo is not appearing good. So what I'll do is I'll just select image size to full, and that's all for that, and I'll just click on update, and we'll see how our menu is looking for right now. So I'll just go to my website and just will reload it, and we'll see how our menu is looking right now. Now you can see how a beautiful our menu is right now, and you can see we have a home page section, contact section, portfolio section, and last one is button. And if you don't want that, I also didn't like that, so I'll just go back there, I'll just go to content there, and I'll just click on default and click on update. Now the whole thing is updated, and that's all for that. And I'll just go again to wpadmin, wordpress.mywebsite.com/wpadmin, and I'll just repeat the process. Go to appearance, go to Elementor header and footer builder, and after going there I'll just click on add new, and after clicking on add new, what I'll do is I'll just replace the footer with header. I'll just select footer, I'll just select here as footer, and display on entire website, and that's all. And I'll just click on publish, and after it is published I'll just click on edit with Elementor, and it would be edited with Elementor. And after it's done, it would redirect to me to the same Elementor page builder section, where I'll just edit the header and the footer of the website, and I will see how our footer is looking for right now. So here we are at the website, and I'll just click on add template. I'll just go to import installed kit templates, as the process is the same. I'll just go to installed kits, and I'll just seek for footer section. So here is the footer section, so I'll just select that one, and the footer section is imported, and now you can see here is the footer section imported. And now you can just change, if you want to change the picture, you can also change the picture from here. Now how to change the picture, just click on edit section. I think it's available in a section. No, it's not in section. So yep, here it is available in, where it is available, I think so it's in, yep, it's in section. Yeah. Oh no, it's an image. So it's an image, and you can add one of yourself, or you can add any other image. So this is the image, you can just clear that out, and you can add one of yourself, and after that you can just add your own email address, you can add your phone number, you can add your address and your country, and you can edit the text. And after that click on update, and your footer is also updated. So that's all about the footers and headers, and now we'll head out to the pages section. Oh sorry, I'll just go back, and we'll see how our website is looking for right now. I'll just refresh it, and and after refreshing you can see our header is created, our footer is created, and now which is left are bit content between. Now we will create the pages and install the kits on pages. Now how will we do that? To make it easy, I just added all the pages in menu section. So first of all we'll just go to home page, and this is the home page I think. And what you have to do is just have to click on edit with Elementor, and after clicking on edit with Elementor you will be redirected to the same Elementor page builder section, and there you just have to do the same thing to import that home page section page template kit, and that's all what you have to do. You just have to go there, and after going there you just have to select that one, and here you just have to insert home page template into your home page. And it might take some time because it's pretty big, so it might take some more time than the header and footer. So here you can see the home page is imported. Now how to edit the home page? That's pretty simple. What you have to do is you just have to click on each section. You just want to change the text, you want to change the color, you can just go to styles and you can change the color. If I want it to be blue, I just can convert it to blue. And if you want background to be blue, you can just go to that section and you can just make it blue, okay? And I just want it the same as it is because it looks pretty good. And after that you can just change I'll just say Khadeen, because my name is Khadeen. So I'll just say it Khadeen. I'll just change the text with web designer. I'm a web designer, okay? And here you can edit your stuff. And here what you can do is if you have any picture, you can just go to remove.bg to remove the background of your picture, and you can add your picture here. Here you can see remove.bg, and here you can just remove your picture. You can see there is a demo here, so you can see they had a picture like that, and the background removed. You can see the picture how it is looking for right now. You can see here if you have picture like that, you can get it like that, and you can upload it on your website how it is. I'm on wrong section I think. Yeah, so here you can add your picture, and here in hire me button you can just edit the text link. I'll just add a link to my website, not website, but I'll just add the link to my WhatsApp, 92317088 7540. So this is my number, so I'll just add it to there. Okay, here you can edit that stuff, and you can edit your WhatsApp link or other links, etc. And here it is. Here is the services section. You can change the picture here, you can change the text, change that. If you want to change the logos, you can change the icons from there. You can just go to icon library, and you can change the you have a huge icon library, so you can change the icons from there, and you can name the services here, okay? And you can just go to the scale section, and you can just change your skills also. If you want to change the percentage of skills, you can just change the percentage of skills. And again, if you want to edit the picture, you can do it. In qualification, you can do the same. It's like a Word, Microsoft Word, like it's a lot easy to use. So here in portfolio section, you can just click on explore more, and you can just add your portfolio page https://ornyourwebsite.com. You can just copy the link to your portfolio. Now how to copy the link to your portfolio? Let's just go there in your website, not your website, but the website I am creating, it's your website. Okay, so I will just go to our website. We'll just go there in this section. I'll just go to portfolio. It's not working for me. So this is a portfolio page, and I'll just copy the link from there, and I'll just paste it here for explore more portfolio, and I'll just go below, and that's how you can just edit your portfolio section and in scale section. And after that Here is your portfolio section. You can add pictures of the products you have done, and you can edit the products and gallery, and you have a product gallery and with some ALT texts here. So you can edit that one off also, okay? So then you have my weapon testimonial section. You can edit the testimonials from here, and my weapons tool section here. You can create a photo with the tools. You can add it here, and you can just add a link to your process also. And how to add the link, I just told you that just click on that link, and in link section, fill it. In contact me section, it's a form here, it's not found here, and how you can select it, you can just go to select contact form, select form, and click on contact form 1, and your form will be created here, and after a few seconds it will be updated. And what you have to do is you just have to click on update, and your form will be updated, okay? Now you can see. So now you can see the form is updated, and I'll just again update the website, and website is updated, and we'll just go to the home page of our website, and we'll see how our website is looking right now. Now you can see our home about page, how home page is looking, how it is looking right now, and I'll show you how this page is looking. So you can see it is same as it is, okay? So now we'll just go to the second section, and we'll edit the second section. Now how to edit that second section, we'll just go to second page, which is about page, and we'll edit that about page with the same process. Now how, let's just discuss it. We'll just click on edit with Elementor, and it would be loaded. And after doing that, we'll just repeat the stuff. We'll just go to that in Envato Elements, and we'll just go to that import template. That's how we'll do it. We'll just go to install kits, and here we'll just select the about template, and we'll just click on insert, okay? And this is the same process, and we'll just repeat the process again and again. And that's all. There is nothing technical in Elementor. There is nothing technical there. And that's the beauty of the Elementor. And that's the beauty of the web design using Elementor. And 80% is done. And you can see the whole homepage is imported. You just have to edit the stuff you have. You just have to edit the pictures. You just have to edit the text. I told you how. And you just have to edit that stuff. And you just have to click on update. And your website is updated. And that's all. Now we'll have to go to to portfolio section. I'll just go from there, or you can just go to menu section and go there from that's a lot easy. You can just go to that section, and if you want to do it by a sequence, you can just go to the portfolio contact section first, but I'll just go to the portfolio section first. You just have to click on edit with Elementor. Now here we are at portfolio page. We'll just go to install kits. We'll just go to that template kit, and I'll just go to that portfolio, and I'll just import it, and we'll do the repeat the same process as we did before, because all the products and all the blocks are similar, and we just have to edit with similar strategy, with same strategy. There is nothing different. There is nothing awkward, or there is nothing out of the world. There is everything that you have learned before, okay? So you just have to edit all that stuff, and you just have to again click on update. And after doing that, we'll just again go back to our website, and I'll just go to contact now. As I told you, you can also use description. That's why I created description, but I know the links, so I'll just directly go from there, okay? So here you can see, we'll just click on edit with Elementor. And after clicking on edit with Elementor, you will be redirected to the that page. I'll just select, I'll just go there. In install kits, I'll just go to, again, I'll just repeat the process, and contact me page. And I'll just import that page, And after that page is imported, you can see this page is imported. You just have to edit the stuff on this page and just import that or update that. And again, now which page is left? The services page is left, and I'll just go there. Now we are at services page. Again, I'll just do it with Elementor. And after clicking on edit with Elementor, there's again the same process again. If you are bored out of it, you can just go back to the, like, go forward and just see that how you can win that tools. If you don't want to see that, I have, that's why I just created timestamps. I'll just go there, and in services section, I'll just import the services page. Okay. And after that page is imported, our website is complete, and I'll also just import that one, or not insert that, but I'll just import that one. Okay, so here you can see the page is imported. Now this is my services page, and you can just change the text and or whatever you want to change, and just click on save. Okay, now it is updated. Now we'll check our website, how our website is looking right now. Now you can see this is our portfolio website that I just showed you in before, and you can see it is same as this one. Okay, and we have a lot other, this website which I showed you don't have other pages, this don't have other pages, this has only sections. But I showed you that how you can create separate pages for it. You can just go to contact portfolio services page, and you have the four pages, and that's all. And that's a lot easy to use, that's all a lot easy to create, and that's how you can create a beautiful website for yourself. And if you want to create similar websites, you can just go to webifiedhub.com/template-kits. If you want to get the latest template kits, and if you want to create other types of websites. Now how, let me just tell you that when you will redirect it to this page, this is the website which have a directory of millions of template kits you want to create. Now if you want to create a construction company website, if you want to create a finance law website, or you want to create an event management company website, or you want to create a blog, you need a template, and you can just go to webifiedhub.com/template-kits, and you can get the template kits at cheapest prices with the same process I just told you. You can create a website. Now here you can see here are a lot of template kits, and if you want any other template kit for your portfolio website, you can just search for portfolio here, and you will get hundreds of website template kits here which you can select to create a beautiful website for your portfolio. So you can see, but that was one I liked, and I created a video on that. Now let me just tell you how you can get these $300 gift just for free. To get these $300 gifts just for free, first of all, you just have to subscribe to my YouTube channel, click on bell icon, and comment on my video. And the second thing is you just have to click on the link below in description. I have given the link to the form, and you just have to go that to that form, and you just have to fill out that form. So this is a bit technical. Let me just tell you how you can do it. Enter your email here, enter your name here, and after that you just have to you just have to confirm that you have subscribed, liked, and commented, and you have to buy a hosting from the link I have given you, or a WordPress template or theme from my link I have given you. Okay, so if you have done that, select one of them, and here you can have to just take a screenshot, or just have, you might have a invoice, and you just have to send me that send me a proof that you just bought that thing from my link. And in description you can add the like view, or you can add how you did it, or if you want any additional, add any additional message, and enter your WhatsApp or Instagram where you just want to get these gifts just for free. And you can just add your both channels here, and just click on submit, and your form will be submitted, and after a short time you will get you will get these gifts just for free. So that's all about the video. Thank you so much for watching this video. See you in next video.